Thank you, Peter Zaitsev. Great presentation. Hello again, Durham, North Carolina.
Hey, thanks, Guy.
So not long ago, not many hours ago, I met you in virtual Paris. Now we're meeting in virtual New York. So as I said last time, you had a couple of observations on the relationship between the MariaDB Corporation and the MariaDB Foundation. I took the liberty of stealing a couple of tricky questions right after your previous presentation. We had an Ask Me Anything session with Monty. It will also be broadcast here in virtual New York. I hope it was fine to steal your questions.
Oh, of course, of course.
So to stay on something slightly controversial, another hot topic, people used the word drop-in replacement or have been using that for MariaDB in relationship to MySQL, especially earlier days. And some people say it still is in practice a drop-in replacement of MySQL. And others then want to enter into religious global transaction ID, GTID wars. So where do you stand on that issue?
Well, I think the drop-in replacement is not super well-defined terms, right? You can range from a position where, well, all the relational databases speak SQL, right? And so you arguably can use them interchangeably, right? To all the way to if any application which runs in situation X could run if in situation Y, right, or product A and product Y, right? And I think if you, and so a lot will depend on your definition, right? Obviously, MySQL and MariaDB, they still remain to be relational databases and speak SQL, and in most cases, they do understand each other SQL, right? So from that point, you can still see it as a drop-in replacement. But now, if you look at the applications, right, user, there may be certain differences. And here, I think a lot have been changing through years. If you look at the earlier MariaDB versions, right, I think especially 5X, right, before 10 came into a picture, those were really sharing a lot of code base with MySQL and have been very comparable. Now there is a significant diversion in the feature, right? Especially if you are looking to use some new features, either in MySQL or in MariaDB. And I think what you also have to be thinking about where things are going. And I would expect that difference to continue to grow as the product innovates with their respectful roadmaps.
Mm-hmm. So let's assume that I am a user, not on MariaDB, I'm on MySQL, and I'm on a release of MySQL prior to MySQL 8.0. So in this world of semi-plugin, drop-in replacement versions, what are my options and how should I be thinking about my future from that point onwards?
Well, I think it's in this case that is an interesting timing because if you look at the MySQL world, the MySQL 8 takes a giant leap in many cases, right? In MySQL 8, a lot of the old conventions have been abandoned. A lot of old architecture has been changed, right? Hopefully for better, maybe for worse, right? Depending on your opinion, right? And if you are looking for something which still behaves as old MySQL and sticks to old MySQL values, yes, MariaDB may be in many cases closer. Right. If you look at about MySQL as, hey, what the MySQL will entail, that's obviously MySQL 8 track. Right. And I think that is one of the things where I'm saying, hey, in the future, comparability more and more diverges. Right.
Right. So listening to your presentation and also earlier versions of it, one of your expressions that stuck to me was evergreen release, which I understood to refer to the fact that in MySQL 8 bug fixes and new features are not separated like they traditionally were in MySQL and that they continue to be in Maria, but they are mixed into the same release. So what's the effect of that? Whom does it affect? Is that an issue for application developers to think about or for customers? Who has to think about that issue?
Oh, yes, yeah, absolutely. I think that is a big philosophical question. There are a lot of different, approaches which exist in modern world, right? I mean, if you look at a lot of a traditional enterprise approach, right, it's often where we are looking about the safety, saying, hey, I deploy the given version of database. I want to make sure I only get bug fixes with a minor releases, so nothing ever breaks, right? And that was traditionally MySQL approach, and that is approach MariaDB continues to focus on. The MySQL 8 focus on the different idea of saying, hey, we as developers, we want to make sure we get the new features faster. Right, the fast of innovation, and also the constant but smaller changes. Right, so instead of saying, "Hey, once per year, I have to do this kind of a massive database upgrade," right, where maybe a lot of things change and I have to go through all the changes in application, I get into the culture what I need to review how my application was involved with every release. Right, like every 3 months or something. You can think about that as kind of more agile, like Scrum development, right? Ideas where there is a lot of uncertainty, right? And it's kind of moves quickly. And I think it's worth to note that the MySQL is not only project which uses this approach, right? If you look at, for example, how Kubernetes evolves, every release in Kubernetes, right? Even you can think about that minor one, introduces and depreciates a lot of stuff, right? So MySQL took the bet of this of a new approach, right? And I think we'll see it will take years, frankly, to see to what extent that was a winning bet or not.
Yeah. So I think we have just a half a minute left, but your question, what you're saying then is that customers don't ever necessarily get a completely stable release, but we'll see in the future whether that is necessary. Is that what you're saying?
Well, I think a stable release, right, is a completely stable release is not a word I would use, right? All the software has bugs, right? And I think that was even highlighted. Mantis Ask Me Anything discussion. Right, from Zulu chat, right? The question is more about the intentional breaking changes, which is at this point, MariaDB does not introduce, and MySQL does, right? To the point of, hey, if I upgraded MySQL from 8.0.20 to 8.0.21, my data format may have changed and I cannot go back, right? Which is, frankly, unpleasant new reality for many.
So sorry for interrupting at such an unpleasant point, but we're out of time and your questions or your answers to the questions were very educational, as was your presentation. So thank you, Peter Zaitsev.
Okay, thank you, Kai.